Welcome back. Well, the Hawaii State Science Fair has taken over the convention center the past couple of days and is now open for public demonstration.
Dallas Ontiveros joins us live from the convention center with more this morning. Hey, Dallas.
Good morning, Kelly and Christine, here at the Hawaii State Convention Center for the Hawaii State Science and Engineering Fair, which has really been taking place all this week. But now that the judging is over, it is open for the public starting at 9 a.m. And here joining us today is Erin, who is an eighth grader. Thanks so much for joining us here on Take Two.
Hi, I'm Erin Nakamura. I'm from Stevenson Middle School.
Thank you so much for joining us. Now, before we get into your science project, because this looks very interesting, tell us what you'll be presenting and who is it helping in particular?
Okay, so my project is the highly efficient PIR motion sensor for the visually impaired. And I also have a partner who is not able to make it here at the time today. But I am helping a girl at my school because there is a visually impaired girl at my school whose vision is still intact right now, but is working with learning how to use long canes so that if and when her vision deteriorates, she will be able to learn, know how to use the technology. Mm-hmm. So I am.
Oh, and I know, and this is a really good idea because I know some alternatives for those who are battling with vision use canes, or, you know, sometimes those aren't the greatest material, or sometimes the service dogs could cost a lot of money, right?
Yes. So existing systems for the blind include long canes, and as I did further research into them, we found that they're not the most effective cost-wise.
Yeah.
Because mm-hmm. they can easily break in half, mm-hmm. and the price can really add up, mm-hmm. as well as guide dogs, which are a great solution but cost thousands of dollars and are a lifelong commitment.
Yeah. Well, I really like this idea, so let's go ahead and see how this works.
Okay.
So what's the first thing we're going to do?
So I'm going to plug it in, and this right here is an ultrasonic sensor.
Okay.
So what an ultrasonic sensor does is it emits an ultrasonic wave that hits an object. And then when the wave comes back to you, it trips the sensor and the buzzer will go off,
okay.
signaling to you that there is something in front of you.
So okay.
I'm going to plug
gonna
it in
it right,
right
now. All right. So, we just got the lights going
right
on.
Now it is not beeping because it is in open space. But if I turn to my board right here, mm-hmm. it will beep because there's something in the 1.5 to 1 foot range.
Okay.
But if I turn here, it will stop beeping because it is in an open area.
Okay, so this will only beep when there is something in the way, and the person who does have this type of glove will know where things are at because of the buzzards, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So, but we are still always with the engineering design process. We are always trying to improve, diagnose the problem, and make it better.
Mm-hmm.
So currently we are working on our third prototype, which is more compact, using an Arduino Nano, which is a different place to put information that is just more compact. And we are also planning on adding a vibration motor instead of a buzzer, so you can rely on feel instead of a sound.
Very nice. And I mean, how long did this take to create?
So I first created a prototype right before my school fair,
prototype
which was in December.
Okay.
And this is a PIR sensor going off of heat waves. Mm-hmm. So with the heat waves going, they will catch humans.
Oh,
so this okay. was my second prototype, and I created this right before the district fair and tested it before the district fair, and it took about a month.
A month?
Yeah.
Wow.
So this,
pretty good.
Yeah, and this is what we are working on at the moment.
Perfect. Well, I think this is an awesome idea. It definitely has a great story behind it, considering your friend is has those vision challenges. But really quickly, as we wrap up,
yes.
congratulations on this project.
Thank you so much.
I want to know what you want to do in the future when you get older.
So over the past year, before this, I didn't know what I wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
But over the past year, I realized how much this has changed my mindset and my thinking, because as I'm outside, I see something and I'm thinking of ways to improve something, and I'm trying to solve problems, and I really enjoy it. So I think I want to go into helping people and solving different problems in the world.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Aaron. This is a great idea. And definitely, if you want to come check out Aaron and tons of other projects, you could come by starting at 9 a.m. The award ceremony begins at 10:30. But come out and support our local students, as young as fourth graders to seniors in high school. She's going to go into high school next year, so she's pretty excited. And obviously, she has a great future. But coming up in the next half hour, we're going to take another look at some creative science projects. So stay with us. It's coming up here on Take Two. Reporting from the Convention Center, Dallas and Rose, saying back to you guys with more.
She's in eighth grade, Kelly.
That's impressive.
Wow.
Incredible.
All right, coming up next, it's a whole new world for a